So basically, we'll start our session with the core Java part. Okay. So as you know that we'll be having core Java and advanced Java, right? Yes or no? We're having
Yes.
core Java and so what is the use of core Java and what is the use of advanced Java? What does it mean?
Core and advanced.
Yes. Do we really have core Java and advanced Java?
No, I think.
We don't have any core Java and advanced Java in real time. Okay, so there's a lot of disturbance, Vijay. Yeah,
From my end, or else
I
I'm
think
getting from your end.
you're getting sound from my end.
Yes.
Everything is fine from my side. Once, can you keep in mute? Now there is no sound. Now, are you hearing any sound? Hello? Please unmute and speak. Yeah. So,
Yes.
if you mute, are you getting any sound?
Yes, I'm getting from your end. It's a kind of some background. Yeah. Now it is okay.
It's okay, right? Fine.
Yes.
Okay. So basically, we don't have any core Java and advanced Java in real-time environment. Okay, so there is no core Java and advanced Java in real-time environment. Then what are the things we are having in real time? Java is given by whom? Java is given by Sun Microsystem, right? Java is given by Sun Microsystem. Now it is acquired by Oracle. Okay, now it is acquired by Oracle. So as per Sun Microsystem, James Gosling, he has given basically three editions for us. Okay, JSE, JEE, and then JME.
JTV, yeah,
JME.
JM.
Okay, fine. So please keep on mute for some time. Then after every 3 minutes, you can speak if you have any. If you have any doubts, please unmute and start asking the questions. Okay?
Sure.
Yeah, fine. Please keep in mute. Fine. So basically, when it comes to Java, we are having three editions: JSE, JEE, and JME. When it comes to JSE, we are going to call it as Java Standard Edition. Java Standard Edition. When it comes to Java JEE, Java Enterprise Edition. Java Enterprise Edition. When it comes to JME, Java Micro Edition. We are having basically these three things: Java Micro Edition. So by using JSE, we are going to develop standalone applications. Standalone applications means desktop applications. Desktop applications means what? Whatever the software we are installing in our system, only we can use. Others cannot use. Those are nothing but standalone applications. Okay? Which are nothing but desktop applications. Standalone applications. Standalone applications. When it comes to JEE, Java Enterprise Edition, used for developing web as well as enterprise applications. Web as well as enterprise applications. Web as well as enterprise applications. When it comes to JME, which stands for Java Micro Edition, use it for developing mobile applications. Use it for developing what? Mobile applications. Mobile applications. Okay. Now, so basically, we'll start our sessions with JSE. In real time, we are going to call it as JSE. When it comes to our learning purpose, we are going to cut our academics. We'll be saying that Core Java and Advanced Java. We'll be saying that Core Java and Advanced Java. Fine. So to develop any kind of web application or enterprise application, basically we have three ways. Totally, we are having three layers we are having. Okay. So basically, to develop any kind of web application or enterprise application, totally we are having mainly three layers. Totally, we are having mainly three layers. What are three layers we are having? One is presentation layer. One is presentation layer. One is presentation layer. Second one is business layer. Second one is business layer. And third one is persistence layer. Third one is what? Persistence layer. Persistence layer. So when it comes to presentation layer, we are going to call it as user interface, UI part, as we had discussed, user interface. So here we'll be having, for the purpose of front end, we'll be having what? HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, basic things. Later on, we'll be having AngularJS, lot of things we are having, ReactJS, all these things comes into front end. As per basic version, we'll be having HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. When it comes to business layer, here we are going to work with Java part. Okay, business logic we are going to write by using Java. And when it comes to persistence layer, we'll be having databases. This is nothing but databases, like we can have Oracle, we can have MySQL, different kind of database we'll be having. Okay, so to develop any kind of web application or enterprise application, compulsory we need to follow these three layers. Okay, so this is about our brief introduction. And so mainly the purpose of learning Java is to develop applications. Which kind of applications means web applications. Why we are learning Java to develop web applications? To develop web applications, we are having n number of programming languages, right? But why we are choosing only Java? This is what our question. To develop web applications. To develop web applications, we have many programming languages. But why we choose only Java? This is what our question. Why we choose only Java? What is the reason? Nowadays, all the upcoming technologies are developed using Java. So if you learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. Any new technology means it may be a Hadoop, it may be a Salesforce or cloud computing, Pega, Android, whatever it may be. All the upcoming technologies are developed using Java. If you learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. Okay, this is what the important point. Nowadays, all the upcoming technologies are developed using Java. So if you learn Java, we can migrate to any new technology very easily. We can migrate to any new technology very easily. Okay, so what are the upcoming technologies nowadays mostly? Maybe a Hadoop, it may be a Salesforce or cloud computing, it may be a Pega BPM tool, It may be a Selenium. It may be Android. All these upcoming technologies are developed using Java. So if you learn Java, we can migrate any new technology very easily. So this is what our brief introduction. Now we'll be starting with JSC part, which is nothing but core Java. Till now, any doubts, Vijay? Please unmute and speak. If you have any doubts, please message in chat box here.
Yeah, sure. I don't have any doubt. Yeah.
Now we are entering into the part of Java. This is what our brief introduction. Okay, clear, right?
Yeah, clear.
Fine. So basically, Java is nothing but an object-oriented programming language. We are going to call it as what? Object-oriented programming language, which is nothing but the purpose of creating an object is reusability. Okay, see here, Java is nothing but, straight to the point, it is an object-oriented programming language. Before Java, we are having C and C++. C is not an object-oriented, and C++ is partially object-oriented. It is not completely object-oriented. So we need to discuss that why Java is an object-oriented programming language. And what is the advantage of creating an object? These things we need to learn. Okay, straight to the point, Java is an object-oriented programming language. Okay, so why Java is an object-oriented programming language? What is the advantage of creating an object? So the advantage of creating an object is reusability. For the purpose of reusability, we are going to use the objects. So to create any Java class, to create any Java program, we need to create a class. Basically, we need to create a class. Observe here. So first we need to know how to create a class. So syntax for creating a class. Syntax for class. What is the syntax for class? Simple thing. Class name. Open parenthesis and closing parenthesis. Inside the class, basically we are going to write variables, methods, constructors, all those things we are going to define. Basically, inside the class, we are going to create what? Variables, methods, and then we are going to create constructors. Constructors. These are the things we are going to define. So we need to know what is a variable, what is a method, all those things. Okay. So before knowing all these things, we need to know about naming conventions. We need to know about naming conventions. What is the use of these naming conventions? Naming conventions means these are nothing but rules and guidelines to write a Java program. Rules and guidelines to write a Java program. Okay, so what are the rules and guidelines to write a Java program? Basically, we are going to create a class. Class, we need to start with uppercase letter only. Okay, even though if you start with lowercase letter, the logic is going to be executed. But why we are having these rules means, for example, you will be working for a certain period of time. After 2 or 3 years, some other person may come and work in the place of you. So they need to understand the logic, right? For that purpose, we need to follow these rules and guidelines. Okay, so class, we need to start with uppercase letter. Start with uppercase letter. When it comes to variables, start with lowercase letter. When it comes to methods, see, and what is the use of variable? To store the value. Variables are nothing but data members in C language. In C language, we are going to call it as data members. When it comes to Java, we are going to call it as variables. And in C language, we are going to call it as member functions. To perform some functionality, we are going to create member functions in C language. Those member functions are nothing but methods in Java. So this one also start with lowercase letter. Variable, start with lowercase letter. If you have more than one word in a variable, then next word, remaining all the words, you have to start with uppercase letter. Okay? Remaining words. For example, int. For example, metadata is one variable. Just we need to take like this. So you have to start with lowercase letter. Remaining all the words, you have to start with uppercase letter. Like this, we can take just as I assume. Okay? Similarly, method. To perform some functionality or to perform some task, we are going to create methods. Okay? This one also start with lowercase letter. Remaining all the words, you have to start with uppercase. If you have more than one word, from second word onwards, you have to start with uppercase letter. Okay, start with the lowercase letter, and remaining all the words, you have to start with uppercase letter. For example, void get data. This is one method. So start with lowercase letter, and remaining all the words, you have to start with uppercase letter. Then interface, it is also one kind of class we are going to discuss later. This one also start with uppercase letter. If you have more than one word, each and every word, you have to start with uppercase letter. Okay, you have to start with uppercase letter. And one more important thing is packages. While creating a package, package is nothing but some group of classes or interfaces. Packages, you have to start with, everything is lowercase letter. There is no uppercase letter. Okay, if you are creating a package, package means what? Everything you have to start with lowercase letter only. Package, all are uppercase letters. And one more thing we are having, that is constraints. Constraint means all are uppercase letters. So these are the naming conventions or rules or guidelines to write any Java program. Compulsory we need to follow all the rules and guidelines. All are uppercase letters. Okay, so these are the naming conventions we will be having. Any doubts here in naming convention? Hello. Okay, fine. Now, in a class, class means what? It is a set of properties, right? Here we will be having two things. Basically, it is a combination of variables and methods, I said. Okay, it is a combination of, we will be having some properties. So here we will be having basically two things. One is variables. Variable means what? Which is used to store the value. Used to store the value. When it comes to method, to perform some functionality, see whatever it may be. Either it may be a core Java or advanced Java, Spring or Hibernate, whatever it may be. To perform some functionality, compulsory we need to create a method. Okay, everywhere. If you want to perform some functionality, we need to create a method. So use it to perform the task or to perform some functionality. Okay. Now I'm going to explain you how we are going to work with Eclipse IDE and how to create a project, how to create a package, and inside the package, how we are going to create the class and how we are going to execute a Java program. Okay. Fine. Observe here. Just first we need to create one workspace. So what I'm going to do is, in D drive, I'm going to create one folder. Right click, new folder, here Java workspace -, I'm going to take it as VJ. Okay, now see here, it will be the Eclipse. I'm using the version as Mars, so the latest version is Oxygen. You can use anything. Okay, you can use Oxygen, you can use Neon or Mars. Just here, if you open this one, we'll be having one globe symbol. Click on this, Eclipse will be open. So click on browse. In D drive, I have given one workspace. In D drive, Java workspace -, VJ, I have taken, right? Just select this one, click on OK. That's it. Okay, basically when it comes to Eclipse, we'll be having two perspectives. Just close this, welcome. We'll be having two perspectives. One is for developing web application, another is for developing standalone application. So this is nothing but a perspective. Okay, if you click on this, we'll be having Java and Java EE. Okay, see here, Java and Java EE. By default, Java EE will be selected. See here, by default, Java EE is there. But so to develop any standalone application as per core Java, select Java, that is enough for us. Okay, if you are trying to develop any kind of web application, for example, if you're developing a web application using Solidworks or JSP or Spring MVC, anything, then you need to select Java EE. So as per our core Java part, I'm selecting here Java. Click on OK. Click on OK. Then first we need to create one Java project. How to create? File, new Java project. So here I'm creating a project, core project. Click on finish. Fine. You need to expand. So as per standalone application, this is a simple workspace here. In SRC, we need to create a package. In SRC, we need to create a package. Inside the package, we need to create a classes. Okay. Right click on SRC, new package. Okay, so here com.madhu.basicsmt. So here com stands for commercial. In real time environment, com stands for commercial. In the place of Madhu, we'll be having our organization name. In the place of basics, we'll be having our project name. Okay, so you can take com.madhu.basics or org.madhu.basics, whatever it may be. Org stands for organization or com stands for commercial. Okay, so com dot organization name dot project name dot, and then we'll be having modules, and then we'll be having modules. Okay, so click on finish. Now we need to create a class, right? If you want to write any Java program, we need to create a class. Right click on your package, right click on your package, new class. New class. Let us create a class called sample. now for me. I'm going to create the font size, preferences, font, basic, text font, okay, fine. And here the Java program execution starts from where? Main method. So even though you write 1000 lines of code or 2000 lines of code, if you want to execute any Java program, first what we need main method. Okay, so how to write a main method in Java? How to write a main method? Simple thing. Main, public, static, void, main of string arguments. Why? Because why we have taken string? String accepts any kind of data. In C language, we are going to write void main, right? Similarly, when it comes to Java, we are going to write public, static, void, main of string arguments. Why we are taking here string? For example, if you take here int, int accepts only integer type of data. Float accepts only decimal type of data. Similarly, when it comes to string, it accepts any kind of data. Within the double quotes, we are going to take. So string accepts any kind of data. And if you want to print anything, in C language, we'll be taking printf, right? Similarly, when it comes to Java, we are going to take system.out.println. System.out.println. So to print anything in Java, these are the basic things. System.out.println of something. Okay. Like this, we need to take. Now the same thing I am applying the basic program. Just I want to create a main method. Generally, how to write main method? Public, static, void, main of string arguments, right? So like this, we are going to write public, static, void, main of string args, right? But what is the advantage of using Eclipse IDE? In Eclipse, we don't need to write all these things. Automatically, Eclipse will generate all these things. Okay, see here. Just I'm removing this one. What you need? You need main method, right? Simple thing. Take main, click on control space. If you click on control space, observe here, 1 minute. If you click on control space, automatically main method will be generated by Eclipse. Even Eclipse is also developed by using Java. Okay, so we need main method. Just tape main, click on control space. If you click on control space, automatically main method will be generated. Okay, now if you want to print anything, system.out.println, right? You don't type anything, just SYSO. Click on control space. Click on control space. System.out.println. Here, this is my first Java application. Or this is my first program. Simple thing. Just I want to write. This is my first program. Save it. Okay. Now, if you want to run this program, just okay, you can click on this. Or else, right click on your program, run as Java application. Right click on your program, run as Java application. Okay, like this, it will be printed in console. Okay, or else you can click on this also. Just if you click on this, automatically the logic is going to be executed and it will be printed in console. Okay, so any doubts in first program? Clear how to create a project, how to create a package, and then how to create a class. Clear, yes. Right?
Yes. Fine. Last thing, Madhu. Yes. Are you what you call recording the session?
Yes, exactly. I'm recording the session.
Okay. Fine. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, fine. So for each and every concept here, I'm going to create a separate package. Why I'm creating separate package? Means in case in future if you have any doubts, directly we can open that package and we can open it. See the classes of that particular concept. Okay, so for each and every concept I'm going to create a separate class. Now one more thing, I want to perform arithmetic operations. To perform arithmetic operations, I'm going to create another class. See here, so n number of classes we can create in a single package, or we can create multiple packages. Okay, a project can contain n number of packages, n number of classes, n number of interfaces, and n number of methods. So for example, I want to perform arithmetic operations. Right click on your package, new class, arithmetic operations, arithmetic. Okay, now see here, In this program, I'm going to explain you how we are going to work with objects. Okay. So to perform some functionality, what we need some methods, right? We need to create a method. For example, void, some method I'm going to create here, logic, it's our wish, any method you can create. So inside this method, I want to perform some operations like arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. So for the purpose of this thing, to perform any operation, we need two variables, right? We need two variables. So I'll be taking int a is equal to 12. Int b is equal to 14. I have taken two variables. Now I want to perform the functionality, right? So int c is equal to a plus b. Int d is equal to a minus b. Int e is equal to a into b. And int f is equal to a by b. I want to print these values. How to print these values? System.out.println of a value is plus a system.out.println of b value is plus b and system.out.println of c value is plus c. Sorry, here I'll take a plus b. Somewhat meaningful, I'm going to take message here. A plus b value is system.out.println of a minus b value is plus b system.out.println of a into b value is plus e system.out.println of a by b value is plus f. Okay, then now if I try to execute, will the program execute here? Will the program execute? What will you be getting here? Previous program is executing here. There is no main method, right? It cannot execute. Even though you write 1000 lines of code or 2000 lines of code, the logic is not going to be executed. So if you want to execute, compulsory what we need? We need a main method. If you want to execute a Java program, compulsory we need a main method. Main. Now, inside the main method, we need to create an object. So how to create an object? How to create an object in Java? Okay, right on. Most important, these are the things we are going to use every time. Okay, now our next point is, what is the advantage of creating an object? And how to create an object? Write on these two things. Mandatory things only you need to write. Remaining things, I'm going to share you all the examples and documents. What is the use of creating an object? And second question is, how to create object? So the two things. The first thing is, what is the use of creating an object? The advantage of creating an object is reusability. So once you write the logic, we can reuse the same code again and again n number of times. Okay, that is why we are calling it as either Java or .NET, or it maybe we are going to call it as object oriented programming language. It means once you write the code, we can reuse the same code again and again n number of times. Okay, write down here the advantage of creating an object is reusability. So that we can save time and memory. So what is the advantage of reusability? We can save time and memory. Okay, and how to create an object? Simple thing. Class name, class name, some reference variable. We are going to call it as what? Reference variable is equal to new class name. New class name. Okay. Now, the same thing here. By using syntax here, we are going to use in Eclipse. See here. So here, what is our class name? Arithmetic. We need to create an object for our class arithmetic. Arithmetic space, and take the reference variable also fully qualified class name. Why I'm saying here to take fully qualified class name means after seeing the reference variable, you should understand that this is the reference variable of particular class. For example, if you take sample s is equal to new sample, so after seeing s, we cannot tell the class name, right? So it is better to take fully qualified class name as a reference variable so that you can understand very easily. Okay, arithmetic is equal to new arithmetic. Okay, now reference variable dot what is our method name here? Logic. Reference variable dot logic. Save it. Okay, now observe here, Java program execution starts from where? Main method. In the main method, what we are having? Arithmetic is equal to new arithmetic. What does it mean? So we are having a class called arithmetic. For that arithmetic class, we are creating an object, arithmetic dot logic. What JVM understands here? JVM understands that we are having a logic method in arithmetic class. That logic needs to be executed first. So after seeing this one, it goes to the JVM, goes to the logic method, and this logic is going to be executed successfully. So whatever it may be, even though you write 1000 lines of code or 2000 lines of code, Java program execution starts from main method. Okay, in this main method, we are calling logic method. Logic method in arithmetic class, that logic method is going to be executed successfully. Okay, like this, we need to create an object, and by using that object, we are going to call the methods. Okay, so the complete core Java, we are going to work like this one. First, we are going to create in classes, we are going to create methods, and we are going to call the methods by using the object. Clear? Any doubts? This is what basic program, how to create a Java class, and how to create methods, and how to create the classes. Just I have shown you the introduction. Now we'll go to the concepts. Just I have shown you how to work with Eclipse IDE. That's it.
Okay.
Any doubts?
So
yeah.
Yes. Can you tell me like automatic how you have created
class?
Class.
Simple thing. Just right click on your package. New class. Okay. Here you need to give some name. For example, arithmetic 1. Okay. Then I have performed the logic. I have created one user defined method. User defined means we are the user side. We are creating a method. And then I have performed the logic. That's it.
Okay.
Clear? No doubt.
Yeah. Right? No doubt.
Fine. Now we will be entering into the concepts of core Java. Okay. Fine. Please keep in mute. Fine. Now the concept is simple concept, data types and variables. Data types and variables. Then we go for object oriented principles, those things. Our concept is about data types and variables. Data types and variables. So when it comes to Java, data type means what? Whether the variable contains which kind of data. So when it comes to Java, totally we are having 8 data types. When it comes to Java, totally we are having how many? 8 data types. 8 data types. What are the 8 data types we are having in Java? Byte, short, int, long, float, double, char, boolean. Totally we are having how many? 8 data types. So byte, short, int and long are for storing integer type of data. Float and double are for storing decimal type of data. Char is for storing character type of data. Boolean is for true or false. Okay, so byte is for storing what? Byte, short, int and long are for storing integer type of data only. So here approximate value is minus 127 to minus 127 to some 128. This is the approximate value of byte. All these, see, these four data types are for storing integer type of data. Okay, when it comes to short, minus 32,767 to 32,768. When it comes to int, this is what the range they have discussed here. Okay, byte means minus 127 to 128. When it comes to short, you will be having minus 32,767 to 32,768, and then minus 2 power 32 and then long minus 2 power 64 to 2 power 64 minus 2 power 64 to 2 power 64. Just basic things remember here, no need to concentrate more. Just I'm showing you the range of these data types. Okay, and then float and double means, see, for example, if you take any decimal value, sometimes, for example, if you take 14 by 5, you will be getting what? 14 by 5 means 5 to the 10, 2.8 will be getting. So if you are getting the exact value, then we will be going for float. If there is any recurring decimal, then recurring decimal means, for example, if you take 10 by 3, you will be getting 3.333. So if there is a that kind of scenario, then we will be going for double. Okay. So if you are getting the exact decimal value, then we'll be going for float. And if there is a recurring decimal, for example, if you take 10 by 3, we'll be getting what? 10 by 3 means 3.333, like this will be. So if it is a recurring decimal, then we'll be going for double. So float and double are for storing what? Decimal type of data. Recurring decimal. Similarly, for char, for storing character type of data. So, and we are going to define it. Single quotations for storing character type of data. Similarly, for boolean, true or false, either it may be true or false. Okay, and we are having one more thing, string, right? For storing group of characters, string is not a data type in Java. Most important point. Okay, right on here. Important. String is not a data type in Java. It is a predefined class in Java. Okay. String is a predefined class in Java. String is a predefined class in Java. Okay. What is the string? What is the use of string? It is used to store a group of characters. String means what? Which is used to store a group of characters. String is used to store a group of characters. So, any doubt about data types? Just we are having 8 data types. Just remember that mostly for storing integer type of data, we'll be taking int, and for storing decimal type of data, we'll be taking float or double. For character type of data, we'll be taking char, and for storing, so for checking the condition true or false, we'll be taking boolean. Okay. Any doubt? Okay. Fine.
So these decimals are already stored in the byte, short, int, integer kind of things, or else like they are just you have written for a
for our purpose. Yes, actually.
For our purpose.
Yes, we'll be defining the variables, right? Just okay. For understanding, I have given you. Okay.
Sure. Okay.
So this is what the range of our integer type of data. It's clear, right?
So it will be going from minus to plus, right?
Yes. Exactly. Mostly okay. we'll be taking int only, and if it is a bigger one, then we'll be taking based on our requirement. You are going to take. Okay. Clear, right?
Yes.
Now one more important concept. From now onwards, each and every concept is very important. Just concept, some put more concentration. Our next concept is about variables. Okay, what is a variable and how many types of variables we are having in Java? Okay, what is a variable and how many types of variables there? So variable means what? Which is used to store the value. Used to store the value. You know, right? Okay. For example, int a is equal to 12. Here, int is what? A data type. Int is a data type. Here, a is what? A is a variable. A is what? A is a variable. And 12 is what? It is the value. 12 is the value. So, the syntax for creating a variable is now data type. Data type. Data type. Variable name is equal to value. This is what the syntax. Okay. So variable means what? Which is used to store the value. But types of variables or kinds of variables. Most important concept is one. Okay. Types of variables in Java. Types of variables. What are the types of variables we are having in Java? We are having basically three types of variables. We are having basically, when it comes to complete Java environment, we are having how many types? Three types. What are those? First one is local variables. Second one is instance variables. And the third one is static variables. Static variables. Totally how many? We are having three types of variables. Local variables, instance variables, and static variables. You need to know about these things. Okay. When it comes to Java, we are having basically three types of variables. Local variables. Variables which we declare inside the method or a block are called local variables. Okay, write down here variables which we declare inside the method or block are called local variables. And what does it mean? And one more thing. So whatever the variables we are declaring inside the method, only we can use inside that method only. Outside the method, we cannot use. That means what? Scope of the variables are what? Only within inside the method. Outside the method, we cannot use. Scope will be only within the method. Scope will be only within the method we can use. Only within the method we can use. Now, means outside the method we cannot use. Second one is instance variables. Instance variables means outside the method and inside the class. Anywhere we can use. That is what the advantage of instance variables. Variables which we declare outside the method and inside the class. Observe the difference between three kind of variables. Okay. Local, instance and static. Instance variables means what? Variables which we declare outside the method and inside the class are called instance variables. And the scope will be anywhere we can use. The variables will be anywhere we can use instance variables, right? Just by creating an object, we can call anywhere and we can use those variables. We can use anywhere throughout our application. This is about instance variables. And third one is static variables. Static variables means which are nothing but constant data. For example, if you take an organization of 1 lakh people, so every employee will be having one ID, every employee will be having one name, but the organization name is same for all the employees, right? So for that purpose, we are going to make it as static. Okay. Static means which are nothing but constant data. And one more thing, instance variables, compulsory we need to call by using an object. Instance variables, we need to call by using object. Remember this point. Okay. Directly we cannot call the instance variables. Static variables. This is also outside the method and inside the class, and we can call directly or else by using the class name. Static variables we can call directly or by using the class name. I'll explain you with an example now. 1 minute. Write down this one also. Variables which we declare outside the method. And inside the class are called static variables. Okay, now the thing is, and we need to declare static variables by using static keyword. Okay, static variables we need to declare by using static keyword. Static variables we need to declare by using static keyword, and we can access directly. Why? Because it's a static, right? We can call directly or else by using the class name. Static variables by using class name, or we can access directly by using class name or we can call directly. Okay, so totally how many? We are having three types of variables. First one is what? Local variables. Local variables means what? Which we declare inside the method, and which we declare inside the method or block. When it comes to instance variables, which we declare outside the method and inside the class, but we need to call by using an object. And the third one is static variables. Static variables means what? Which is nothing but constant data. These variables I'm going to explain you now with an example. Now see here, for the purpose of variables I'm going to create a separate package. Now how to create a package? Right click on src, new package, com.madhu.variables. Now create a class, right click on your package, new class. Let us take a class called sample. Now here int a is equal to 12, int b is equal to 14. These are which kind of variables? Can you tell me? Vijay, please unmute it.
Hey.
Yeah. These are which kind of variables now? Instance variables. Why? Because outside the method and inside the class, right?
Yes.
This is also what? An instance variable.
Instance variable.
Okay,
inside the method,
inside the class. Next, now here I'm creating a method void show, or else simply I'll take add method, or else. Now here int x is equal to 14. So x and y are which kind of variables here now? X and y are which kind of variables? Inside the method. Inside the method means what? Local. Inside, right?
Local with.
Inside,
yes.
Means local. Local. Yeah, this is what? A local. This is also what? Local.
Local.
Right? So,
yes.
Here. Int z is equal to x plus y. Now, system.out.println of x plus y value is z is which kind of variable here?
Inst.
Z is a local variable, right? Inside the method only we have,
yes,
declared, right?
It's a local variable.
Exactly. Okay, so you need to understand the concept. Static int m. So, and one more thing what you need to do, Vijay, is, so after the completion of session, whatever the concepts we have completed, all the concepts you need to search in Google. You need to get some extra information, right? Then you'll get more knowledge.
Yes.
If you listen only the class, then you'll be getting just what I know. You'll be knowing the same thing, right? If you go to the Google ones, you'll be getting some extra knowledge. Those things, you should not forget. Every day after the completion of each and every concept, you need to go through Google. Every concept. Okay? So, after reading this concept, if you are having any doubt in convention or any sentence, you can message me. So that I'll clear your doubt. Fine, don't forget that. Now, fine. Static int. So these are which kind of variables?
Static.
These are static variables. We have declared by using static, right?
Yes.
Simple thing.
Yes.
Static. So these are the three kinds of variables we are having in Java. Okay. What are those? Local variables, instance variables, and static variables. Now.
Okay. X, Y, and Z are local variables.
Exactly.
So in that way we can.
Exactly. X, Y,
remember,
and Z.
Right?
Yes. X inside the method we are writing, right? Whatever
yes.
the methods we are declaring inside the method are called what? Local variables.
Local variables. Yes.
And whatever the methods we are declaring outside the method are instance variables. If you are declaring
oh, yeah.
by using static keyword, then those are what? Static variables. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now. Okay, first I'm going to create an object for our class. Our class name is what? Sample, right? Sample.
Yes.
Sample is equal to, observe here, I'm using the control space. I'm not typing anything. Okay, if you click on control space, automatically that is generating. You need to observe those things also. Okay. Sample is equal to new sample. Now, sample dot add. Now, if you run this sample, x plus y value is 29. Okay. Now I want to add the instance variables. Into c is equal to, I'm taking here a plus b. It is showing an error. Why it is showing an error? Why?
Because we didn't write int c instance variable
instance,
in the bottom. This.
Instance variables we need to call by using an object. Did we call by using an object? Directly we called, right? Should not
yes.
call like this. Instance variables compulsory. We need to call by using the instance or by using the reference. See here now. I have kept and comment we are going to keep in double slash. Okay. Remember those things.
Mm-hmm.
We are having two ways to keep a comment. One way is by using double slash. And second way is, for example, I want to select this code and I want to put in comment. Just select this code and control shift to backslash. Means slash. Star and at the end star slash. Okay, just select the code and keep in comments. Understood what I said now?
Okay.
How we are going to keep the code in comments in Java program. One is
mm-hmm.
if it is a single line, double slash, and if it is a multi line, slash star. Okay, I'll write here. This is also important concept. Comments in Java, one of the concepts in Java. Okay, understood, right?
Mm-hmm.
Single line
yes.
comments and multi line comments. Okay. Comments in Java. Okay. Write down these points. We are having two types. Single line comments and second one is multi line comments. Single line comments means what? Double slash.
Double slash.
It is, the code is going to be hided. Okay. And multi-line means slash, star, and at the end again, star, slash. This is what I showed you, right?
Yes.
And in Eclipse, if you want to keep in comments, the shortcut is control, select the code and control shift backslash. Okay. Control shift backslash. Control Z. Now, here I'm adding the instance variables. Into c is equal to, I said that by using an object we need to call, right? sample dot a plus sample dot b, right? That's it, right? This is what the reference variable, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now here I'm going to take addition of instance variable. If you go through the document, what I have given, the same thing what I'm explaining here, the same examples we'll be having in the document. Okay?
Okay.
Yesterday, have you gone through the document?
Yes, I didn't go through everything, but I'm just going through by page and page. I'm on the fifth or sixth page.
Mm-hmm. So, that is an easy way, right? Is it easy or difficult? Is it understandable, everything?
Yeah, it is understandable, but the thing is we need to concentrate on the things.
It should be very fast, actually. Actually, I would
yeah.
like, most probably I'm thinking to complete today and tomorrow core Java. Now and
okay.
today evening means for you, tomorrow morning I'm going to take 2.5 hours to 3 hours, and again tomorrow also Saturday and Sunday. Okay, one score in advance is completed within 3 or 4 days, and next 4 days we need to go through spring and hibernate, and then again you need to revise, right? Restful web services,
yes.
All those things. Okay, then you can explain the project in an easy way. That's what I'm thinking. Fine. And once you, can you send your resume to me?
Yeah, sure.
You need to explain your project also there. Do you have idea in your project?
Previously what I did, I have idea, but with the two more projects, I don't have that much.
You need to explain the project also there. Whenever you are going for face to face, they will be asking, the first thing is explain your project or explain about yourself. If they ask you about explain about yourself, just you need to give about brief introduction about you, and you need to explain about your project for 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, what are the technologies used in your project, and what are the modules you are having previously? So what are the limitations we are having if you don't use that project, and what is the advantage of your project, and why you have used only these technologies? These things you need to explain in a clear way. Okay. Then they'll start asking questions on your technologies. The basic thing is clear, understood, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So it should be, and you should revise a lot everything. Even if you start Spring or Hibernate, whatever it may be, RESTful Web Services, every day you need to revise Core Java. I think I have sent you one Core Java document yesterday, right? You need to come back to one also. Fine. So see here, static variables I'm calling you here directly without creating an object. Or else we can call by using class name also. I have said two ways, right? By using class name, or else we can call directly.
Yes.
Okay. No. Please keep in mute for some time. Save it and run it. Okay. This is about our three variables. Local variables means which we declare inside the method. Second one is instance variables. Instance variables we need to call outside the class, outside the method and inside the class. We need to call by using an object, and then static variables. Static variables we can access directly. Clear? Any doubts? So any doubts in variables?
No.
Okay, shall we go for object oriented principles now?
Yeah,
what's your time now? What is your time right now?
12.
What?
12.
12. So, can we listen for some time, or shall we continue more time in tomorrow's morning?